Welcome, everybody. My name is László Gyarmati. I'm from the University of Szeged, and I'm really glad that I have the opportunity to show you this presentation, which title is Methods to Decrease Carbon Emission at the University of Szeged. First of all, where are we? University of Szeged is one of the largest university in Hungary, which is in Central Europe, and we are in South Hungary, in a beautiful city near the river of Tisza, and we are really proud of that university, which I'm going to give you some numbers. The University of Szeged has 21,000 students. We have around three campus sites scattered all around the city. We have around 800 academic and administrative staff, 12 faculties, and we are really proud of that. We were in the top 20 university in 2014 at the GreenMetric survey. Well, we are really proud of that also, that we are the greenest university in Hungary, and we can hold this title every year when we submit the survey at the GreenMetric University ranking. One more title. Last year we participated in the impact rankings, which goal is to monitor the sustainability development goals of the universities, and we were happy to receive the information that we were in the first 200 universities in all ranking. So this is where are we right now, and I'm going to talk about you that what would like to achieve in the near future. When I have to speak about the sustainability efforts of the University of Szeged, I always talk about two pillars of sustainability. First pillar is the environmental conscious behavior promotion. We held lot of and hold lot of events in the field of sustainability. We have Earth Hour programs, Earth Day programs, climate tours, stress-free day, Green Film Club, and we always try to do some environmental friendly program for the visitors at the one of the main building of the university, the Study and Information Center, for the students of the university and for the employees of the universities as well. The second pillar of sustainability is the technical solution. We are really proud that the University of Szeged can use the energy of the sun by solar panels, solar thermal collectors. We use the energy of the urban wastewater as well, the sewage of the city of Szeged, for heating and cooling, for example, this building, which I'm in right now. The main goal of my presentation, to talk to you a few words about the new goals in the University of Szeged, which are aimed to tackle the challenges of the CO2 reduction. We have three ongoing projects right now, and I'm going to talk to you about every project a little bit in more detail. First of all, we have a widespread carbon footprint evaluation with the Követ Association for the main building of the university, the Study and Information Center, because before we set a target goal, we have to know really exactly where are we right now. We had a carbon footprint evaluation, and with parallel that we are trying to enhance the adoption of the technical solutions which can reduce the CO2 emission of the Study and Information Center and of the University of Szeged as well. And right now we are creating new education methods for students, for employees and visitors of the university as well. A few words about the carbon footprint evaluation with the Követ Association. Last year, we conducted a survey, at the end of this, at the beginning of this year, we conducted a survey for the visitors and employees of the Study and Information Center. And we used two data gathering methods. We used online and offline surveys for the center's visitors. As you can see, we had a quite huge sample, nearly 2,000 visitors conducted this survey. And with that parallel, we went through all the building management system documentation to see what kind of services and what kind of energy usage are in the energy mix of this building and contribute to the CO2 emission of this building. At the survey, we asked 33 questions from the visitors in the field of transportation, in the field of nutrition, in the field of waste management, and in the field of environmental conscious behavior. Here are some results. First of all, we know right now the exact CO2 emission of the Study and Information Center in the year in 2019. And as you can see on the chart, the CO2 emission of this building without the transportation of the visitors is around 5,000 tons. As you can see at the chart below of that, if we see the portions of that CO2 emission, we can see the largest portion of CO2 emission is the energy, and the third largest portion of CO2 emission is the travel of the employees to that building and from that building to their houses. We were really interested in about the opinion of the visitors about the environmental conscious themes. And as you can see, we get some really interesting results. When we asked them that who can do the most to solve the environmental problems, they said in the ranking that, first of all, the governments should do the most to solve the environmental problem, environmental problems. But if we ask them that how could citizens to be encouraged to live in a more environmental conscious way, they said that in Hungary specifically, we should create more and more conditions for selective waste collectors. And after that, we should give financial tools to the citizens, sharing best practices, and so on, so on. So this is right now where we are. The second ongoing project right now to tackle the CO2 emission in the University of Szeged is to enhance the adoption of the technical solution. Right now, I would like to give you two examples with which we could obtain in the last few months. First of all, at the Study and Information Center, which has five functions in the university, it is a great center for the main library of the university. We have a conference center here. We have the student services in this building. We installed two frequency inverters at this building, and with that installment, in the next years, we can lower the CO2 emission of this building by 100 megatons, and this installment has a rate of return in 2 years. So it's a really great enhancement in our building management system. On the other hand, we have a huge achievement as well. With the help of the Ministry of Innovation in Hungary, we managed to obtain 5 electric cars in the University of Szeged, and those cars are used to substitute the old diesel cars which are used in the city center, for example, petrol duties, blood transportation, emergency blood transportation for operations, and so on. So with this installment and with this purchase, we will be able to lower the CO2 emission of the car fleet of the University of Szeged around 15,000 tons. The third pillar, which I would like to talk to you a few words, is to create new educational methods for students, employees, and visitors. Because we have a huge data available for us about the opinions and the habits of the visitors of this university, the students, the employees, we are right now creating new teaching methods to inform them, to give them advices, to give them tools, how then can they lower their CO2 emission at their work, at home, through transportation, and so on. Here are a few pictures about these explainer videos. We are working to give unique educational material for every target group who were in this survey, and we would like to publish those new explainer videos and educational methods at the end of this year. I really hope that in the next year I can give you more and more examples about what we were achieved, and I'm really glad that I had the opportunity to talk to you about a few words about our investments, our goals, and of course I'm more than happy to answer any questions if you would like to ask me. Thank you.